Found out that on May 14th, Horvath met some friends. They invited him to stay for the week, and he did. The friends were Drew and Libby Sherwood.
It could have been a good friendship. Like, he was a very likable, very personable person. And for him to just never, you know, not even so much as a postcard. Like, I didn't know his plans if he was heading to Hong Kong to see his mom. But he was the kind of gentleman. He had our address and stuff that he'd said he would keep touch.
On May 22nd, Horvath left the Sherwoods and checked into Tiny Town Campground.
He had, you know, dressed fairly sharp, and he was fairly clean cut, you know, fairly good looking young man.
Phil Flett owns Tiny Town. He says Horvath was like many of the transients that use his campground, there one day and gone the next. 2 weeks passed and he noticed Horvath was gone. He just assumed he'd moved on, so he packed up his tent and other belongings and put them in storage.
After 2 weeks, I'm sorry, you took his tent down.
Yeah, maybe three or four even.
Yeah,
we just basically fold his tent all up and then put it in a box or wrap it all up and tie it up and stick it in there in the shed, figuring that, well, if he comes back, here it is, right?
But Horvath never came back, and Tiny Town eventually got rid of many of his belongings. Things like photographs, papers had been thrown away. Some of his clothing had been given away.
I guess I didn't care. I never understood why they didn't hand his belongings over, but it got to be inhuman not to have cared. Oh, an ounce of concern that it's odd that this boy's left all these things. It wasn't as if they were rags, these lovely, you know, two lovely sweaters which somebody helped themselves to and took them.
What happened to his personal photographs and papers and things? Did you throw those away or did you keep them?
We had them for about, it was the next season in the spring when we're cleaning up the shed, you know, getting ready for another season, and then we had all this stuff and just went through it and, well, this guy's left it gone, filed it in a box and must have tossed her in the bin.
You never thought that maybe somebody might want that stuff, photographs of his mom and things?
Who would we send it to? This is a transient from Europe. Who would you get in touch with?
The last concrete sighting of Horvath was on the 26th of May when he worked one day at Flintstones. Alan has spent thousands of dollars on posters trying to tweak somebody's memory, and last week it paid off. This letter was delivered by cab to her motel room. It says, "Dear Mrs. Allen, I seen your ad in the paper looking for your son. I seen him in Tiny Tent Town, May 26th. We were partying and two people knocked him out, but he died. His body is in the lake by the bridge." There was no name with the letter. Allen says it reconfirms what she's believed for 3 years, that her son is dead.
The day I found the tent, I thought he was dead. He wouldn't leave his photographs.
The Sherwoods have always thought Horvath's disappearance was suspicious. They say the police should have suspected it, too.
To me, Tiny Town is very transient. So, whoever he's met in there probably isn't even from the Okanagan Valley.
Maybe they're gone now.
Yeah, and I think if the police had got on it sooner, maybe the trail wouldn't have been so cold. And if it took this letter to get them motivated, I'm glad it did. But whoever sent that letter, I wish they would have sent it sooner, to make the police stand up and realize, hey, maybe this is legit. Maybe we did have a murder in this town that hasn't been solved and it's unexplained.
If something like that happened at Tiny Town, do you think you'd know about it?
I would hope that I'd know about it, but I have no information on that at all. Never heard anything about that at all.
Never heard any rumors or anything that something sinister had happened to Charles?
Not one.
We don't know where he is. We don't have any ideas at all.
Kelowna RCMP say the letter is being investigated, but even it isn't enough to prove that Charles Horvath was murdered, and for now, there will be no dive.
A particular part of the Okanagan Lake has probably seen more divers than any other area. I know that there's been a lot of police dives on previous cases. There's also been attempts to clean up the Okanagan Lake around that particular part, around the bridge. So I believe if there was a body down there, it would have been discovered by now.
I need to know that he's dead. I'll never stop searching for him till I find him.
The cabbie that delivered the letter picked it up on Bernard Avenue. Alan was out the next day trying to find the person who wrote it. So far, the author hasn't come forward.
There's somebody in this city who knows exactly what happened and is either not saying it for fear of knowing who did it and doesn't want to stand up because they're afraid it might happen.